The way mostly we've seen death anxiety, and there's some very, very good studies, as a fairly negative thing. In other words, when people's death anxiety or mortality salience is triggered, they grasp for things that give them a sense of belonging or a sense of importance or a sense of self-esteem. And that can result in, for instance, distancing themselves who are different from people who are different, associating more with people who are similar. So fairly negative kind of effects. And I think there's another side to death anxiety, and that is that if people can stand with death anxiety, something opens up. Something better, larger, their sense of the world actually expands. It's a bit what we talked about before, the experience of interviewing people, for instance, who are close to death. Sometimes what you find is a much larger sense of the world, not a narrower sense of the world. For me, it's also the explanation why when you go to a palliative care unit, despite the fact that people are dying, there's a sense of calm that's probably not present in the rest of the hospital. What I think is that most of medicine is fleeing from its death anxiety. You know, it's trying to do everything it can to deny it, to almost pretend that, you know, there is no problem, we're not dying, and that the answer is to turn towards that. And that's what palliative care initially did and stands for. And that changes everything, I think. So you don't back away from death anxiety, that you go towards it. That doesn't mean you kind of push at people the fact that they're dying. No, but they'll sense whether you're really afraid of this and don't want to talk about it, or whether you're quite willing to talk about it and you're open. And then they'll choose, do they step into that or not? But that makes all the difference. Patients test us. They want to know, can this person actually be there when things go bad? And if the answer they get is yes, that's huge. That's the kind of support and accompaniment we're talking about. It's not any fancy kind of footwork. It's not skills and communication. It's not anything you learn by doing, you know, some process of steps of anything. No, it's, are you really willing to be there or not? And if you are, that'll get communicated, and that makes all the difference. Because I think what people are afraid of is getting abandoned, you know. And you see, you can get abandoned because of my death anxiety. I may not intend to abandon you, but if you're dying and I'm not willing to take that step forward, I'm going to find a way to not be there for you. And that's going to leave you abandoned. And that can happen with your family too, right? Because your family are going to be scared. They may wish the best for you, but it may be very difficult for them to stand in that space.